Hello and welcome to IT Chronicles 10 in Tech, coming to you from Knowledge 2017. I'm Shane Carlson, here with my co-host Carlos Casanova.
Hi, Shane.
And today with us we have Johnny Jimenez from Univision.
Johnny's
a customer of the ServiceNow platform, and he was kind enough to join us today to talk to us a little bit about what they've been doing and kind of what he's excited about. Johnny, you've been at the show for a day and a half now here. What do you think of what you're seeing from ServiceNow?
Well, I like the big push that they're doing with the AI and their continued performance analytics modules, those type of things that they're working on.
Excellent. So what is it about the performance analytics? I know, from past history and in talking to you that you guys at Univision are very analytics focused. You like to dig into the data. What are you seeing out of performance analytics that is exciting for you?
Well, the performance analytics, before they were talking about forecasting and doing these type of things, analyzing trends, but it still took some manual intervention where these guys had to be a group of BI guys that actually did that for you and set that up. And now with what they're pitching with the artificial intelligence, where it could pick up on trends and kind of, shift it that way, it's a little bit more automated.
So with that in place, what sort of value is your company going to be able to garner from that? You know, obviously the ones that we always thought, the basic performance, but now it's much more than that. So what do you see the value really coming from them capitalizing on that?
Well, again, those performance analytics, those metrics and key indicators are really time sensitive. The idea that your VPs or CIOs can see these metrics and they can pull levers at will, they can't wait for a week for a BI group or something like that to put together analytics that is going to take too long.
So just a much quicker turnaround on that, huh?
Absolutely. You always want a much quicker turnaround in the sense that any of your metrics have to be actionable.
Yeah.
If you're just looking at reports for the sake of showing numbers, you're not really doing anything with them.
Right, exactly.
So I know Univision, you guys are a media company, and obviously you've got a lot of technology on the traditional IT infrastructure side, but you've also got a tremendous amount of technology on the broadcast and the customer side. Talk about the challenges that you guys have balancing, managing those assets across multiple domains and environments and different business purposes.
Well, that's a good question, because a lot of times some of our pain points with the assets are who owns those assets and what are the cost centers, and getting the actual customer to understand how those assets work and how they relate to common CIs. They're used to working with CIs, which is really for the technical side or the propeller heads. They're fixing stuff, they want to know what it is.
Right.
The asset side that should be tracked by the managers as sort of financial ledgers, that's where we need to kind of focus on and let the managers run their reports against that, where their lower level managers are creating reports against CIs because they're tracking equipment and break fix.
Yeah, right.
So they need to step it up one layer and learn how to use the asset records.
Yeah. Right, and that's the challenge too, because they're the same. A lot of times they're the same thing. They're the same item, just being looked at from different perspectives. And I think we lose that, right? We really lose that connection between the business person saying, "Hey, here's what we're paying for," and the operational person's like, "I just need to fix it." So I mean, that's a disconnect that we've been seeing for so many years.
That's correct, and some of the enterprises that have downsized their staff, you're talking about the same person that's doing that type of report, and they lose themselves in the next layer where they have to hand that report up, where a VP, a CIO, they don't want to see all these bars and metrics. They want to see, four quadrants to say, this is where we're at, this is our assets, this is what's available, and how we're doing.
Right.
So I know another theme of the show here at Knowledge has been talking about utilizing the ServiceNow platform outside of the traditional IT enterprise, doing a lot of what they call enterprise service management, HR functions, facilities, legal. Are you guys looking at doing any of that at Univision?
We actually are. We have our own HR platforms inside, so we're still addressing that conversation, and that's part of our roadmap going forward. So we're going to look in how to really get this as an enterprise platform. Let's say not necessarily do what HR does, but all the services that HR require around what they do.
Yeah, kind of in that white space that exists between the HRIS systems and the HR case management, we're something that's a service and workflow platform might be able to fill the gap. I understand.
Yeah, and that's where we usually drop the ball, right? The provisioning, is HR, but it's really provisioning of IT devices. And we, you know, we've all been in this long enough, there's always a gap and something slips through.
It is, and I think that gap starts where when they take and IT inserts itself in this process, they're midstream. You know, it doesn't start upstream where it starts with HR and it's a thought through process.
Right.
They have their platform that they do their work, and everything else they really don't want to know about. They let that float downstream, and it has to be caught by the service providers.
Yeah.
So is there anything you've seen in the last couple of days of the show that's going to either change what you guys were planning to do at Univision, or has kind of inspired you to go back to the team and say, hey, guys, I saw this, and maybe we should go in that direction?
I think it would be the latter. I mean, ServiceNow has a lot of new technology that continuously coming out to help the business in the process. Right now, we got to go back and make sure that the people know how to digest all this information that's coming out, all this new technology, and how to leverage it for their existing processes, fix what's broken.
Right. And from a maturity perspective, there's always things that you take on at certain points, and we're just going to do a little bit of it. They come out with new releases and, you know, more maturity, more capability. And it's like, oh, yeah, maybe let's take a look at that again now. They have a lot of capabilities on the platform.
Absolutely. I mean, with my experience, not just ServiceNow, other platforms and other applications throughout the years, what I've seen in IT is that customers own a product and they only leverage 10% of it. They come to the shows and they get excited about these new functions and features, which really they already own and they have. They just haven't leveraged it.
Yeah, they get the cart a little ahead of the horse sometimes and forget what they paid for. A lot of talk too about automation, machine learning and artificial intelligence. There's quite a few vendors here on the floor that are addressing pieces of that. ServiceNow is talking about that. Any plans to leverage any automation or machine learning?
Absolutely. I mean, if we can get our level one service a little more efficient, some of these guys, remember, they're very technical and they're not attuned to the different business processes. So it takes them longer to figure out categories, subcategories, and areas where they should be looking at those records. So now they're losing time because they either have to put a lot of thought into it, where is this going, or hand it up to a upper level management to categorize it for them.
Or put it in wrong and it goes in circles for the
next 2 days. Exactly.
So
at the end of the day, some of these SLAs are literally breaching because of that, because it's been handed from one hand to the other because they don't really know what the other teams do and where the categories go.
Right. So is there one thing that you're not getting out of your current tool solutions today that if you could wish for, what would it be?
A more succinct discovery.
That's a good one, actually.
Yeah.
It's a very good one. Yeah. Excellent.
I mean, Ty, obviously that's kind of a hot spot for me, right? More just on the technology side, or more maturing of maybe touching a little bit closer to that business side of discovery, knowing obviously we can't discover conceptual and logical things.
Well, I mean, it, just in its basic functions, when we turned on discovery, we got a billion CIs, and I said billion. and it was things that belonged to a computer. We got NIC cards, we got MAC addresses.
The mini ports.
Mini ports. We have all these things. Yeah. That were not associated with the whole.
Right.
Hey, this is a computer and these are the functionalities of it. No, they were logged as separate CIs.
Yeah.
So for somebody going in and trying to look for a piece of equipment that they're working on, and they are challenged with the number of different CIs that are in those tables, it's just a daunting task.
Sure.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Johnny, thank you for joining us today. It's always good to get a customer perspective on where things are. Appreciate you coming out.
Well, thank you for having me.
Thank you, Johnny. Appreciate it.